that, man.
If you had the chance to change the situation, would you take it?
Cruising down the street in my 6'4".
Hey, that was dope, eh?
I'm coming straight out of Compton.
Hello, and welcome to Reelz Talk. I'm Angel Pierre.
And I'm Zanai Lewis.
This week, we'll take a look at diversity, and what better film than the late summer hit of 2015, Straight Outta Compton.
The film has made over $200 million worldwide and was nominated for an Oscar. It has won countless other awards along the way. Straight Outta Compton tells the story of Compton's own NWA and their rise to fame in the late 80s and early 90s.
The true story touches upon various controversial issues within the music industry regarding diversity. Iona students gave their reactions to our very own Matt Ricker.
I would say diversity is having a mix or a variety of things. So whether it's food-wise or in groups of people, keeping to yourself, but mixing them together so that you get a bunch of everything.
Diversity is when like a group of different like cultures, races, religions, genders, whatever gets together.
Diversity is the representation of all cultures and communities in one setting.
I think it was a great movie. It really like showed like even like some issues that have happened in the past, like in the 90s, still exist today. It really painted the streets of Compton and just like the whole group as a whole in like a perfect sense. I really enjoyed the movie.
You had a group of people who were drug dealers, gangbangers, I guess, in a very horrible area, and they came out and they spoke up against a lot of things that people were afraid to talk about. And they had a huge impact. They rallied a lot of people. A lot of people disagree with what they were talking about, but look where we are today. It's like little things like that, speaking out against things that you think are wrong.
I think one of the most important elements of diversity in this movie is the fact that at one point they did gain support from a white producer, unfortunately. His name slips my mind at the moment. I think another thing that plays an important role was that one time that they were in the neighborhood outside of the studio and the cops came and just gave him a problem for no reason.
I think it was a really good film. I think that it did a good job at conveying diversity with its cast and just the story itself.
I felt women were kind of just unnoticed. They were really in provocative roles except for the maternal roles. So I feel like there could have been a lot more women in the story, especially the mothers. I feel like they had a stronger role.
Y'all just got a snapshot of how Americans really feel.
We gave the people a voice. We gave the people truth.
The time frame in which this movie was released is perfect. Everyone's talking about Black Lives Matter, Blue Lives Matter, and the debates are going up back and forth, and it was interesting to see what it was like 20 years ago.
Definitely, this film gave audiences a platform in which they can discuss their feelings towards racism and police brutality, in which they previously had to conceal. Police brutality is definitely still a thing today. The film was based in the late 80s and early 90s, but today in 2016, police brutality is still a big deal.
One of the most controversial scenes in the movie is a scene where the police officers are actually encountering the artist outside the studio, and it sparked a lot of raw emotion from audiences all around the world, and I think that was very interesting to see what it was like 20 years ago to experience something like that.
Definitely, because as you know, the film was taking place in the late 80s and early 90s, but it hits a nerve for audiences because these things are still happening in 2016, nearly 20 years later.
I think the directors and the actors did a great job of making sure they pinpoint that it was diversity within the music industry, but so many other things stemmed off of that. Diversity just in general, racial differences, gender differences, it really brought it all together into the one film.
Speaking of gender inequality, there's a particular scene in the film in which they're in a hotel, and women are shown in many different aspects in just that scene. So it shows a bit of gender inequality in the music industry itself.
I think that was one of the things that was frustrating for me personally as a woman, was that the female roles that they had were either a mother figure who were kind of encouraging the artists to become whoever they meant to be, but then also like these females who weren't wearing clothing, who were just there kind of just as support or background for music videos, and there was no actual feminine role that was strong in the film. And I think it has a lot to say with what was represented for women at that time.
Right, although the movie was to portray what actually happened for NWA, and they may not have had a female manager, but we could have seen a female at least in the studio.
Empowerment.
At some
yes.
point, definitely, being in having a role in NWA at all, instead of just being like a video vixen or a mom.
Iona College professor Nadine Cosby, who's a writer and director whose works are heavily focused in gender, racial, and cultural representation, sat down with our Brandy Gonzalez for an interview on her expertise.
I think what the movie pointed out most is kind of a lack of diversity in the way women are represented, obviously, in the music industry. And then after that, I think it also highlighted how sometimes, you know, artists of color are taken advantage of by like white producers, because especially if we're talking about artists that are coming from kind of an underprivileged or an impoverished area, they're excited about the opportunity to change their financial or socioeconomic position, right? Standing, but at the same time, they can very easily be taken advantage of because they don't have that experience or someone really overseeing what's happening behind the scenes and making sure that they're getting a fair deal. So it did highlight some long-standing issues in the music industry. You know, I didn't find anything groundbreaking because what was this? This was a movie about something that actually happened 20 years ago. So if anything, it only highlighted that not a whole lot has changed. If we look at music videos today, right? Do they still make music videos? But if we look at music videos today, if we look at the way women are represented today, not much has changed in the music industry, right? I guess the two things that kind of jumped out at me, and I mentioned them a little bit before, one was the way that women were portrayed, but also what was interesting was that I felt that they left out a lot of narratives that actually took place with NWA and their interactions with women. I think a lot of people know there's kind of an infamous violence that Dr. Dre was known for having, you know, these kind of altercations with women, and that was totally kind of left out of the film, and the focus was on the women that were groupies and wanted to be around them and all of that. So that was one kind of underlying theme, but again, also the unfairness in the music industry at that time in regards to the way these young artists were treated and taken advantage of. I think it has us talking, which is good. I think it was a movie that so many people wanted to see, right? It had this wide audience demographic, which was great because I think a lot of younger people who are really into hip hop today got to see a little bit of the behind the scenes and what was really happening at that time that they're probably unaware of because the industry itself is so different right now. So it definitely has us talking more about it, and it's kind of shining a light on some of the things that are wrong, that are still wrong after all these years.
Our art is a reflection of our reality. What you see when you go outside your door?
I know what I see.
And it ain't glamorous.
I think it's helped because it's shown that in a way that a lot of other films haven't. You know, those two themes were kind of the focus of the film. So I think it's made people aware in that sense. And again, there's a lot of history there that I think most people today were not aware of. So just showing that and maybe giving people the ability to compare portrayals back then versus today and seeing that they're not that different goes a long way in allowing us to talk about it and be more aware of what's happening and how the music industry treats women. We have to get to a point where, first of all, a black person can take on a role because they're a great actor. And it's, you know, there's depth in that character and in that role, and not because that role calls for a black person. So when we get to that point, there will already be kind of automatic change. And we have to get to the point where a great director, you know, a black director can just be a great director that directed a fantastic script, right? And it doesn't have to be considered a black film. When that happens, and that really starts in like the marketing stage, it automatically decreases the audience population, because when something is presented as a black film, what it's saying to non-black audiences is that this isn't for you. The Academy has to realize that films are just films, right? And an all-black cast or a predominantly black cast is the same as an all-white cast or predominantly white cast. But what's happening in the industry, and what's always happened in the industry really, is that an all-white cast or predominantly white cast is considered the norm. All right, so that's a regular film, right? It's just a movie. An all-black cast is considered a black film. And it's not looked at as a story or, you know, what's the particular narrative. Instead, it's looked at as a black film. It's marketed that way. And for the most part, black people go out to see it. And that's about it. So looking at it that way, there's really not much of a chance for those types of films to even receive a nomination, much less a win in the Academy.
Thank you, Professor Cosby, for your insight on the aspect of diversity in Straight Outta Compton.
I'm Angel Pierre.
And I'm Zanai Lewis.
And thank you for tuning in to this week's episode of Reelz Talk.
All right, bruv.
Yo, I'm 21.
This week, we'll take a look at diversity and what better film.
I think probably one of the more important...
Wait.
Diversity has become a hot topic lately.
Straight Outta Compton's storyline.
Ice Cube, Eazy-E, and Dr. Dre. I gotta tell you, you are witnessing history.